So here what happened, Mrs. Pompeo is giving Pompeo is giving so much food to his dog. And then doctor advised him, if you are continuously giving this type of food to him and not giving any type of exercise, not taking, so he will get really ill. I tried the sound severe. Now I really means this. If you have don't give him, write down the food and give him more exercise, he is going to be really ill. You must harden your heart and keep him on the very strict diet. This was advice given by Mr. Heriot to Mrs. Bromfield for him. Mrs. Bromfield worked her hands. Oh, I will, Mr. Heriot, I will sure you are right, but it is so difficult, so very difficult. She set off head down along the road as if determined to put the new regime into the practice immediately. So the writer, Heriot, Mr. Heriot, or Dr. Heriot, the writer, he was the same. He advised Mrs. Prabhupada, she is not going to listen. And then what happened? Doctor was continuously watching Tiggle's progress, but he was not satisfied. And soon it has happened that dog was just be ill. He scribed regimen means the prescribed exercise, whatever is there. So, but she's not listening, and that is what happened. I watched their progress with a gloomy concern, growing concern. Tickle was tottering along in his little tweed coat. So the writer is saying that I was watching his progress daily. But what happened? Tickle was tottering, means move in a feeble or an unsteady manner along in the tweed coat. Tweed is a woolen cloth, most probably it is found in the Scotland. So he had the whole wardrobe of these coats for the cold weather and and a raincoat for the wet days. So here Mrs. Tickle said that doctor explained the luxurious life of the dog, that he was living in a very luxurious life and not doing any exercise or hardshipness. That is why he was suffering from the this problem with the fats. So he struggled on the dropping his harness. I thought it wouldn't be long before I heard from Mrs. Frompe. And he thought that after some days she will come to me that my dog was not well, and then I have to already Mr. Heriot make a plan, and according to that he had done. The expected call came from within a few days. Mrs. Frompe was distraught. Trickle would not eat nothing, sorry, refused even his favorite dishes, and beside he had bouts of vomiting. So what she complained to doctor that he refused to eat, and he was just a short after short period instantly he was doing for them he was doing bouts of the vomiting, and he spent all his time on the lying of a rug, not moving here and there, not going for walks, not playing anything. I had made his a plan in So doctor said that I have made already plan. Whenever this condition will come, I will take the dog from Mrs. Pompey and I will treat him properly. So I had made a plan in advance. The only way was to get Trickle out of the house for a period. I struggled that he be hospitalized for about a fortnight to be kept under the observation. The poor lady almost swooned. She was sure he would pine and die if he did not see her every day. So the doctor is saying that I already planned that I will take to him for the 15 days under observation. But in the end, that lady thought if the tickle was not watching me, not seeing me, so he will die. So like that, she thought. So that is the thing. Here next, but I am looking firm line. Tickle was very ill and this was the only way to save him. In fact, I thought it the best to take him without delay. So doctors already thought that I have to take him under my observation, then it will be cured. So he said strictly that I have to take him to the hospital. Followed by Mrs. Prompey's wailing, I marched out to the car carrying the little dog wrapped in a blanket. So what Mr. Harriot had done, he had just took the tickle with him. He was just wrap him in a blanket and put him in his car. But what happened at that time, the whole staff of Mrs. Prompey was moving here and there, and they will bring all the things, whatever of the tickle. They just want to send with the doctor. And the doctor's already car was full, and then he wants to go away from there because all the staff was crying. That lady is also going to be crying. Even her condition was that that she will be faint within some minutes if the doctor, a few minutes, if the doctor was not going away from there. So that is why what happened. The entire staff was aroused and made the rush in and out bringing his day bed, his night bed, favorite cushions, toys and rubber rings, breakfast bowl, lunch bowl, supper bowl. Realizing that my car would never hold all the stuff, I started to drive away. As I moved off, Mrs. Prompey, with his despairing cry, threw. Despairing means harshly, very fastly she was crying. So, despairing cry, threw an armful of the little coats through the window. So, even after then, she just threw some of the coat in my car, inside my car. I looked in the mirror before I turned the corner of the drive. Everybody was in tears, means the whole staff, and Mrs. Prompey was just crying that I will take the dog away from there. Out on the road, I glanced down at the pathetic little animal gasping on the seat of my side. I patted the head and the tickle made a brave effort to wag his tail. Poor old lad, I said, you haven't tickle in your, but I think I know a cure for you. So what the doctor said to him, to that dog, he was just patted his head and said that I will cure you from this, whatever happened to you.